Brother, brother, brother. The world is getting to be in a sorrier state. I shouldn't say that. Well, I have to say that. I guess you heard the news by now. I heard it late because I've been studying and I haven't been paying attention to the world. But there was some sort of attacks in France, Paris, France, a bunch of places, including a venue where they was having a concert or whatever it is like that. And it was by the Islamic State. You know, well, it was about a bunch of people that want to blow a bunch of things up, take vengeance on something that was done here, there, there. It was like a back and forth, like a tennis match, you know. Mm-hmm. I'm sorry, I sound like I'm making it petty. But here's the thing. Now I listen to a certain circle of peoples, you know, because, you know, I'm you know, Black American, you know, African, North American, you know, African, Americana, so from the Middle Passage tribe. So there's social media with, like, Black people. And Black people are saying, like, okay, we hear you, but, you know, you're more than these 120 or whatever people. What about the, you know, the people in Kenya just got bombed, or the people in Nigeria, for that matter, the Congo? You, nobody goes up and say, hey, you know, mourn for these people. You know, it doesn't get around, you know, the globe, the attention, stuff like that. It's kind of dicey there, you know. I mean, I say dicey, but I'm just trying to say, that's the, what we call a Black perspective. They say, okay, we hear you, but hey, nobody wants you. In fact, now it gets even worse, because then people start digging into stuff. All sorts of theories and past things come up. For instance, here I'm wearing my old Africa t-shirt. This is even before Africa was Africa. This is just, you know, they ain't got no countries on here. You know what I mean? Mm. Well, ain't nobody, you know, when the invaders start, you know, beating up and taking people out of Africa. First they take the people, well, they're taking the people out, well, taking the people out, but I'm sorry, first they're taking the resources out, then they took the people, then they went back to resources. Now there's people and resources involved with people. A lot of the theories go like, well, they're trying to depopulate Africa because, you know, we're the only continent that has all the stuff. And so I say, hey, we get rid of these people. And they say, no, this conspiracy theory was like the Ebola and the AIDS and all this other stuff. Hey, it's made in laboratories and all this stuff is going around. Now, whether it's true or not, that's a whole other thing. In fact, I have this saying. Well, it's my saying, but you can apply it to the situation. I'm probably wrong. But you have to prove me wrong. Now, all that says is that stuff is happening. I might be wrong about what's happening, but it's happening. And you got to prove that what I'm saying is wrong about. But when you try to prove that I'm wrong, then you got to come up with the answer about what's right. And it's still going to apply to what's going on. You see how that works? Hey, I think it's a pretty good saying myself. You know? Okay, I made it up, but I'm saying, you know. But here's the thing. All I'm saying is, like, when they had the eugenics movement, or even before eugenics movement, when Hitler's guy, Goebbels, whoever was down in Namibia, killing all of them, whoever was down in Namibia, killing all of them, the genocide and down there, you know, first the death camps or whatever have you. Hey, the world wasn't saying stuff like that. In fact, it was academics, PhD people, when they came back, they were supporting that kind of stuff. But now, all this stuff comes back to, let's call it, the Northern Hemisphere. Stuff happens in the Northern Hemisphere. And now people are going to get all, hey, something needs to be done, needs to be done. And the people here saying, like, well, sure, it needs to be done, but you need to address some other stuff and stop raping your mother, Mother Africa, raping up his children, raping up his minerals, raping up his resources, you know, all this stuff. Okay, look, I'm going far afield. I'm just saying, it's in the embers. I say, it's a bad situation. You know, that's all. I don't even have a big word for it. It's just bad, bad, bad all around. But somebody's got to stop doing something. So something gets back right on course. I don't know if that's possible because, you know, the money people and the arms people, they like what they're doing, you know? So let's be stopped. I don't know. Anyway, this has been one of those dispatches from the Arts Director Emeritus. And that would be me, T, from the Patterson's Taking the Train to Tibet, letting you know what I only suspect. Mm-hmm.